Al Bernstein here with Steve Kim from MaxBoxing.com, who, by the way, was one of the press row scorers on Showtime.
It was easy tonight. It was very easy tonight.
Yeah, we didn't have to worry about it in the main event with Brandon Rios and Urbano Antillon. This was an astonishing fight, even though it lasted only a couple of rounds.
You know what's funny? The fight that you're familiar with, Hagler-Hearns lasted about 8 minutes.
Yeah.
This lasted about 8 minutes.
Yeah.
So it just goes to show you quantity and quality can be, you know, kind of dispersed. And quality of a fight does not necessarily mean distance. And tonight was fun. No matter how much you paid for a ticket, this was great action. I'll tell you one thing about Brandon Rios. I was talking to Bob about this. This could be a better version of Margarito or Gatti in certain ways, because by the time they became stars, there was a lot of wear and tear.
Yes.
And I think for one thing, with Margarito, Brandon Rios is technically better balanced,
yes.
Two-handed fighter,
yes.
Shorter with his punches. As it relates to Gatti, at the similar stages of their careers, he's taking less punishment. Now, that high-pressure style is going to be a little bit different. It's like an SUV. It's not fuel-efficient. So he's not going to be Bernard Hopkins at 45, but forever long as it lasts, if I had to pay to watch Brandon Rios fight, I would.
Yeah.
And you know us media members, we don't pay for a damn thing.
No,
you know the way we
There's go. No free lunch, nobody goes. So at 135, it feels like nobody is strong enough to deal with him. We don't know that for sure. There's still some good fighters. Is anyone at 135 strong enough to hurt him, do you think?
Well, see, it's not going to be about...
Well, Costa hurt him briefly.
The style is going to be more important. See, if you're going to beat Brandon Rios, you better be able to work from the perimeter, slow down the tempo of the pace, and keep him from the outside. There's a guy out there that if he gets his stuff together, and he's now with Freddie Roach, has the style to beat him. That's Jorge Linares.
Yeah, now, excellent fighter.
Who has been stopped, though. But Jorge Linares is a very slick, fast fighter, very fast combinations, great hand speed. He's an artist in the ring. But we don't know if he would succumb to that pressure. See, here's the thing. Certain styles are going to give Brandon Rios troubles for the first six, seven rounds, but it's a race against time. It's 36 minutes. Acosta was beating him for 18 minutes.
Yes, he was.
He could not sustain it for 36. That's the key.
And he even had him hurt, Miguel Acosta, who's also an excellent fighter. Finally, Brandon Rios likely to move up to 140 pounds. Could that division get any hotter? I mean, it's amazing.
It'll be interesting. I hope that Golden Boy and Top Rank can put their differences aside, because there's a lot of good fights to make. Just look at Guerrero Maidana, the winner of that. How about Michael Katsidis? But I'm just saying, there's a lot of good fights. The thing about Brandon Rios is, him shadow boxing is a good night of, is entertaining, as I like to say. And that's kind of the way Brandon Rios is. I think, here's the thing, tonight the ticket sales were a tad disappointing. I think from this point on, I think within 2 years, we're not going to be here doing a Brandon Rios fight at the Home Depot. You know where we're going to be? We're going to be at the Staples Center. I think he might be the next Mexican star. And see, the thing about Margarito, he arrived to a point when the expiration date was kind of maybe past it. Maybe the Cotto fight was like the end of his prime. Here, I think we're going to see this prime blossom right in front of us.
Very good. Steve, thanks very
Absolutely,
much.
Absolutely, Al.
All right, Steve Kim, MaxBoxing.com. And later on tonight on Boxing Channel, more coverage. Stay tuned.